Thomas, a data and applied scientist on the Azure SQL team. Today, I'm joined by my friend, David Peter Hansen, who's on the Docs team. So can you tell me a little bit about what you do, David Peter?
Yeah. So my name is David Peter. I'm a senior content developer on the documentation team on the Advanced Analytics. We write documentation about advanced analytics and AI and machine learning. I'm the lead for Azure SQL Database Machine Learning Services and SQL Server Machine Learning Services and SQL Server Language Extensions, where we are then writing the documentation for these areas.
Awesome, cool. So today I think you wanted to show us some of the stuff we're doing with Docs and kind of some of the stuff you've been working on?
Yeah, so some of the documentation we recently created was around Azure SQL Database Machine Learning Services, which is currently in public preview. So we've been expanding the documentation a lot in that area to be able to help our customers get on board and try out these new features, make it easier for them to get started.
Awesome.
So some of the things we created here is a quick start. We have one that creates and trains a predictive model, very simple one, around that. So rather than just scroll through here and show you the entire thing, let me actually show you in how it works within SQL Azure SQL Database.
Awesome. So you're going to show us kind of the quick through and kind of the quick start and run through it with us.
So we have two quick start. The first is very simple. It's very similar to this one where we basically have a very simple R script. So Database Machine Learning Services, basically what you can do is you can run R within Azure SQL Database.
Right.
So you are able to do predictive analytics and machine learning within the database, and rather than having to move the data out to your compute and pull it back in, so now you can basically run the compute where the data resides.
Awesome.
So I have a super simple script, which is a bit silly here, where an R script where we have some variables like A is 1, B is 2, and C and so on. And the last thing I do here is just I multiply C and D, output it as a data frame. All of this is, if you can run this from like RStudio or RGUI or something like that, it will give you an output. But what we're doing here is we're running it within Azure SQL Database using this stored procedure here called SP Execute External Scripts. And we give it a language, and at the moment we have R support, but more languages will follow. In SQL Server, which has a similar, so the on-prem product, we also have Python support, and with language extensions, Java and more languages will come.
So you're using SP Execute External Script here, but is it possible for me to use RStudio or?
You could use RStudio as well to connect to it in the compute context of the server and then run it on Azure SQL Database as well.
Gotcha.
So this is very simple, so I'm not doing it right
now,
but it's absolutely possible.
Great.
And what you'll notice down here is just some of the parameters is that I have the output parameter set to E, so that's my E variable that I've come out here, and I'm just going to return a result set that is the output of this. So let me try run this real quick. There we go. So we can see here that we have the output of 2.5. So very simple. It's not really that interesting, but it's just to show, okay, this is running, and all of this is running in Azure. It's not running locally on my laptop in any way. We can also, let's do a little bit more complex. So let's say we have some cars here, and those cars has a speed and distance, for example. So let me create a table that does that. And actually then we insert some data here. And this data set is one of the sample data sets that comes with R. So you'll see here that I'm simply just taking cars and I'm inserting in to, now I have an input table that is the car speed that I just created. So let me run that. So I'm going to go here and create a model, build a model. And within that model, I have a formula, some R code in there that then goes and uses this data from the car speed to go and predict the distance from the speed of the cars, how fast the, and the distance is a braking distance, I should have said that. So the braking distance of these cars, depending on how fast they're speeding.
Gotcha.
So let me go and create this, and I'm gonna go into all the details. If you want all the details, go to the quick start.
Yeah.
It's all written in there, so. So now that I have this model, I would want to store it somewhere. So what I want to do is create a table where I give the model a name, and also then the model itself is stored as a var binary max within my SQL server, so that once I built and created my model and then trained it, I can store it in there so that we're able to use it. So you don't need to do that over and over again. So that you then.
So right now I can have it and I can call it later.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
So let me go and create this table here, right? And then I will simply just go and execute this stored procedure and insert the output, which is the model, and insert it into my table that I just created.
Cool. And so what will this return now?
So right now, basically the stored procedure returns the binary model from our itself that is then stored in the database. So we haven't done anything except we built the model and we trained the model.
Gotcha.
On the data. So let's me go and create the table here. And with this new data, and I think can then go here and again call an R script. So that's R script takes goes and first I get the model that I stored from my stopping distant models table that I created. I then take that model and I unserialize it, so I get it back into R. I use the data from the new data car. So you see down here I have a data input that is that table that
right.
I just created. And I can then go and use RxPredict to go and predict the distance of these things. All right, so let me run this one. Takes a little bit of time. And we can see here, these are the different speeds that I inserted before. And then there's a predicted braking distance depending on how much the car, or how fast the car actually
right.
was.
And intuitively, you know, this kind of makes sense. It looks like the faster the speed, the longer
the braking distance, right? So it's a very, very simple example of this. And I know I went very, very quickly over it. So what you could do is go to our quick start here. And it had all the descriptions about what this particular example does. If you want something a bit more advanced, we also have more in-depth tutorials.
Okay.
So we recently created two tutorials, one that builds predictive models in R and one that where you're building a clustering model
in R.
Clustering
model.
Yeah, so we got cool. that as well.
There you go. Now, if I'm going through one of these yeah. tutorials or quick starts and like I have a question or I get stuck on something, like, can I email you?
No. So I'll result in a lot of emails. But there are two ways. So if you find something that is like, okay, you think this might be wrong, or if you find a typo, for example,
right.
or if you want to help improve and contribute to the documentation, there are two ways of doing that. The first one is to go all the way to the bottom here, and you see you have this feedback button. So if it's about the product, you can click this product and it will take you to the product part of it, which is our engineering group that will respond to that. But if it's about the documentation itself, you can click on this page. And that will take you to GitHub. So all our documentation is written in GitHub. So actually this box behind here is GitHub. And we create a GitHub issue, which then actually will send me an email.
Yeah.
So
it will indirectly
send me an email. and we will then get back to you about that issue.
Awesome.
Another way is, let's say you find a typo or there's something that you think, oh, let's improve this documentation anyway. Another way is because all our documentation is open source.
Mm.
So you can go up here in the top and simply click the edit button. So if you go and do that, you see it takes us to GitHub, and that's the Azure Docs is the GitHub repo for all our Azure documentation that we have in there that's open source. And you can see here, this one is under SQL database, and then SQL database tutorial predictive model prepare data.md. So the .md is because it's a markdown file. We're using Markdown to write
all the docs. Oh, cool.
And simply to go and edit it, you click on this little pen here, and you can go and click and edit the documentation itself. And now you can see, yeah, this is basically just Markdown that we have here. Let's say we find a typo in there. Once I'm done, what I go down here, I go and I write, I find fix typo, for example. And then I would then go and click propose changes. And
someone will review
yeah,
it.
And then that will go in and create a pull request, which
awesome.
We will then go and review. And if everything looks good, you will get merged into the documentation and contribute to it that way.
Great. Awesome. Well, thanks so much for joining us, David Peter. You know, I hope our audience learned a lot. I hope you all like this video or comment and let us know what you're doing with Azure ML or Azure SQL Database with machine learning with R, and check out our docs and even, you know, start contributing.
Thank you so much for having me here.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you,
guys.
Thank you. Bye.